15 News at 6.
Case closed.
Now at 6, Madison's most high-profile squatters are kicked out.
It's a story you saw first on NBC 15. The woman who just moved her family into an empty West Side home has now left.
NBC 15's Zach Schultz was the first reporter on scene when Madison police asked her to leave.
No problems whatsoever. They were expecting it.
It was a quiet ending to a very short stay in a foreclosed home on Madison's southwest side. Madison police arrived at 8:30 a.m. to ask Desiree Wilson to leave the duplex where she was illegally living.
We came here this morning, told them the legal standing that that they had there, which was none, and we asked them to move, and they said fine.
Desiree was moved out by the same group that moved her in 10 days ago. Operation Welcome Home is part of a growing movement to put homeless families in foreclosed homes.
Hey, we're here to celebrate the first housing liberation in Madison.
They called a press conference Monday to announce Desiree and her two children will be squatting in this empty home.
We're trying to figure out state by state.
Z Harkness is the group's leader. He says they knew this was the likely outcome.
From every step of the way that we've been open and honest with Desiree, she's been on board with what we're doing, and she, you know, she wanted to improve her situation as one, but she also knew that this was part of a bigger movement.
Their first problem was they thought Bank of America owned the building, but it's still in foreclosure, and on Tuesday, the Verona man who does own the building asked police to kick her out.
I know there's people that think we should have gone immediately, but it takes time to make sure we have all the facts, that we had someone that has standing there say that they don't want them there.
I'm very glad to see this happen. It should have never have happened.
Brenda Sweeney is a neighbor and says the only public support was for eviction.
I really don't think they proved any point. They've gone about it all wrong. They're doing it illegally.
Z won't say what their group's next move is, but he says they will continue to challenge the law and try and put homeless families in empty houses.
We have gotten calls from people who are homeless and people who are ready to do this. We need to regroup with the community and figure out where people want to move.
Case closed.
Zach Schultz, NBC 15 News.
Desiree and her children are not out on the streets tonight. They are back living with her parents, where she was before she moved into the duplex. Since Desiree's family is doubled up with another, she technically qualifies as homeless.
This is your Weather Authority 4.